In this video, we're going to discuss IPLV, integrated part load value for a water-cooled chiller, and the standard that defines that formula and the conditions. This is the IPLV, integrated part load value, how to calculate chiller IPLV. What is IPLV? Integrated part load value. It's based on part load efficiencies calculated on the weighted percentage of assumed operational hours at each condition. So there's 4 points that are going to be measured. This is an average efficiency of a single chiller. Most chiller installations will have multiple chillers. So this is rating for a single chiller. So the IPL formula is 1/1, and these are the 4 points, A, B, C, and D. These will be the efficiency of the chiller at the different loads, which we'll get into next. But we're going to take condition A. We're going to take 1% of condition A. 42% of the time, the chiller runs at condition B, 45% of the time it runs at condition C, and then 12% of the time it runs at condition D. So what is A, B, C, and D? So what it is A, 1% of the time, and these are the 4 points that are going to be measured. The EER for these 4 points will be put into the calculation. So A is 1% of the time the chiller is running at 100% load. B, 42% of the time it's running at 75% load. And 45% of the time it's running at half the load, 50% of the load that the chiller is rated for. And D, the last point that's going to be measured, the EER, 12% of the time it's running at a quarter load. So these values will be put into the calculation. These 4 points that the chiller runs at, these percentages of load. So when it's running at 100% load, we're going to put that EER in the calculation. We're also going to put in the calculation the value of the EER when the chiller's running at 75% load, and again at 50 and 25. So step one is to determine the part load energy efficiency value for these four running loads, these 4 points, at 100%, 75, 50, and 25, just like quarters. And these conditions are the AHRI standard 550 conditions. That's the Air Conditioning, Heating, and Refrigeration Institute standard 550, which specifies certain conditions that these is measured under. So step two is to insert your formula. So all we need now is to grab a sample of what the EER is for a particular chiller. So I have one here. So we're going to say this particular chiller that we're looking at, this water-cooled chiller, when it's running at 100% load, it has an EER of 0.63. At 75% of load, it has a better EER, it's running at 0.43. And at 50%, 0.29, and 25%, 0.27. So all you do is take these numbers and put them into your calculation, and you'll get the IPLV. So here's the values that we got. So at 1% of the time, the EER is at 0.63. 42% of the time, it's at 0.43. 40% of the 45% of the time is at 0.29, and 12% at 0.27. So you can see it's hardly running at full load, and full load has the worst EER. So put that into calculation. I have a spreadsheet that I made that easily calculates it for me. So the 0.63, the 0.43, the 0.29, and the 0.27, it comes up with an IPLV of 0.335. So that's integrated part load value. So you can see you can put multiple chillers in here and compare them. So what is AHR standard 550? Basically, these are the conditions under which the standard is developed, and it shows at the condenser entering water and temperature at 100%, the condenser water is 85 degrees. And as you can see, as the load drops off, the condenser water temperature drops off. And it's considered at 3 GPM per ton. And the evaporator is considered a leaving water temperature at 44 and the flow rate at 2.4 GPM per ton. So if a chiller is to run it other than those conditions, other than the AHRI standard 550 condition, then it's considered non-standard part load values, NPLV. So the other one is integrated part load value. And if it doesn't fit within those conditions, which most of the time you're probably going to find it doesn't, I'm not going to go into that calculation, but this is the IPLV calculation, and it's based on a single chiller. And most data shows that 80% or more of plants usually have multiple chillers. And so the IPLV doesn't accurately represent plant operating conditions. Energy analysis tools provide a better solution, and it's used to compare unloading characteristics of similar chillers. So that's a simple explanation, a quick explanation of IPLV, and it's just a simple calculation of the EERs at the different loads. That's 25% load, 50%, 75%, and 100% load. 4 points of the EERs for that chiller into a calculation to get its part load value, because it's the chiller's not running most often. It's probably not running at 100%. It's sized for 100% load, and that's the worst condition, but it's not going to see that. It's going to hardly see that. Maybe 1-2 days out of the year. Most of the time, it's going to be running at part load value. So it's a quick calculation to come up with the IPLV, which is also part of ASHRAE 90.1. So hope you liked it. Subscribe to our video. Thanks for watching.